Hi everyone, hope you're doing well. Welcome to this third workout, Pilates session, 15 minute routine. Follows on really well from the upper body session that you've had already, the leg routine, and then this. You can do them all in isolation if that's your preference, or you can team up and do them all together. They go work really well, upper body, legs, then this, or perfectly well in isolation. Now we're gonna work on two body shapes, box position, and then we're on our back. We're about control, holding shape, poise, form, or control so that you hit the core as we start to move arms and legs as I challenge you. Now, pick your level. Make sure you're not straining, putting in too much effort. All right, quality over quantity. Here we go. Focus on poise, control, and form. Okay, let's go. Box shape to begin. Flat hands or fists. So I'm going to assume that you're not warm, okay? So press out position, slowly lower, breath in, breath out, sit back, okay? Okay, we'll do six of these, just to warm your body up. Remember, you don't have to go all the way down. You can just do little half ones. Okay, remember, your chest comes forward. You're just warming your body up a little bit before we get going, okay? Warm up your core. Mobilizing your back, warming up the arms a little bit. Okay, last one. Sit backwards. Okay, now we're gonna get into our box shape. It could be on hands or fists. Zip that lower tummy up. Relax through your shoulders, chin tucked in. Okay, starting with your right hand, breath in. It elevates. Come back down again. You're not allowed to shift your body off to the side. Maintain a nice, strong, square box shape, okay? So we're zipping the tummy up, elevating the arm, using your core muscles. Two more. Hold your shape. Light touch when you come down. Now you're gonna move on to your left arm. What I wanna see here, okay, when you do this, is that your body doesn't shift off, okay? So you maintain that nice square box shape. Relax through your shoulders. Feeling those core muscles working as you try to maintain a nice strong box shape. One more. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna use the legs, okay? So in that box shape, hand directly under shoulder, knee directly under hip, tummy zipped up, relax through your shoulders. Right leg slides along the floor, it's not lifting, just sliding. You've got to push away through your tummy. Push back through your tummy, hold your shape as you come in. So the leg lightly hovercrafts, all right? It never relaxes. That way you keep the tension where it needs to be. Hold your shape. Hold your shape. Short breath in, breath out, slide. Change your legs, okay. Relax through your shoulders. Zip the tummy up. Can you maintain a nice, strong, square box shape without letting your body twist, rotate, contort? Hold your form. If you hold your form, you're gonna start to feel your core muscles working. One more. Okay, let's sit back, let's stretch the back off, release your wrists. Okay, now you can stick with just arm, just leg, or you can combine. So we're gonna do arm and leg if you're able to hold your shape. Okay, so left leg, right arm, here we go. Slide in the leg, arm comes in. Now if you can, light touch under the body. That stops you from resting. Because I want to keep those tummy muscles locked in.
I want to keep challenging you to hold that strong box shape. Challenging you to hold that strong box shape. One more. Okay, we're gonna change sides. Now you can, right, if you're feeling good, you can allow your leg to elevate, okay? But the slightly easier version is keep the foot in contact with the floor, right? So pick your level, don't over egg it. Here we go. Light touch. Hold your shape, hold your shape. So the leg doesn't have to go miles, the arm doesn't have to go miles. It's all about keeping that rock solid box position. If you're feeling good and you've got control, you can let your leg come up a little bit in the air. Let's do one more. Control that movement. Leg going out, hold your shape. Okay, we're gonna sit back, again, release the wrists, stretch your back out. Okay, another drill in this box position. It's called the Jekyll or box lift. Toes tucked under, hands under shoulders, using your tummy to lift the body up. Okay, so quick demo, we breath in, breath out, 1 to 2 inch lift, and back down again. Resist the temptation to arch your back. Okay, we're not hunching. Lift from the pelvis. Breath in. Breath out. Up we come. 3, 2, 1. So as your breath runs away, you return back to the mat. Breathe in. Relax through those shoulder blades. This is nice because you're not only working your core, but we're loading the legs a little bit. We're loading the arms. Working around the shoulder blades. So we're hitting lots of different muscles, but challenging you to hold a strong box, strong core to facilitate that. Okay, now either stick with this movement or when you're airborne, take a leg back if you can hold your shape. We return down in between, breathe in, breath out, other leg. Up, then it goes, back in, return. That's too much. Just the box lift. Other leg. Okay, so we're trying to keep the shape. Body will try and shift loads of weight forward. Try and keep it centered through your pelvis. Readjust your shape every time if need be. Here we go. One more each side. Last one. So either up and hold or up with the leg stretch. Good. Back down. Sit away. Now from here, you're going to come onto your bottom. We're going to control a roll back. So roll on your tailbone. Allow your body to roll. Let your spine flex. Hold on if you need to. Legs are bent. Next exercise, tabletop. So from here, we're gonna be elevating one leg, okay? So start with your right leg, lower tummy on, lift from here. Breath in, these are on as you breathe out. Use these to pull your right leg up to tabletop. Light touch, look, light touch, light touch. Breath in there, breath out, lift. Hold, breath in, breath out, lower. From here, light touch. Down. Light touch, core is flat, prevent the back from arching. Don't brace too hard. Moderate efforts. Okay, let the reps build that intensity. One more.
lifting from here, okay?
It'd be easy to use your leg muscles to do this, but can you use your tummy muscles? Transition, hold the tension. Left leg's turn.
Hold, breathe. And as you lower, breathe out. Remember, light touch. Ribs are flat, think washboard stomach. Using lower tummy here, also a little bit higher up, around that rib cage to keep the ribs grounded. When you return to the ground, pause, pause, pause. Okay, from here, lift your right leg up to tabletop. Left leg will follow. Hug the knees. We're gonna do what I call rock and roll. So rock and roll, some of you will be familiar with, some will not. That's literally hugging the knees. Rock and roll up into sitting. Little stretch forward. Then we're gonna roll back on our bottoms. Let the spine hit the ground one at a time. Feel the tension here. Roll back. Good. Now, back in the tabletop position. Control, get there with good technique. Abs on. Exhale. Second leg. Hold that 90 degree shape. Arms up. Palms facing forward. Breath in. As you breathe out, your arms are going to go back overhead slightly. So your hands just past your hairline. Breath in. Breath out. Keep the tummy on. Don't let the ribs pop up. They stay flat. They stay on. Feel that tension. Starting to work a little bit higher up. We're challenging those lower tummy muscles to keep your legs where they are. We're challenging your upper body, your upper tummy muscles, to control the arms. We're communicating with what's going on down here. Couple more. So remember this arm movement. We're coming back to this arm movement in a minute. Hug the knees. It's rock and roll again. Up in the sitting. From here, we roll back. Hold on if you need to, right? If you need to hold on, you hold on. That's fine. If not, control that rolling. Control that rolling. Mobilize the spine. Good, legs are bent. Okay, abs on as you take one leg up to 90, then the other. Both arms come up. So we're gonna make this a little bit harder. So as our arms go back, we're gonna extend one leg, okay? So as our arms go back, we extend one leg. Okay, let's start with your right leg. Breath in, breath out, go. Like a V shape, V position, back in. The leg that's not moving is dead still, it's static. Don't let the leg that's not moving start coming too close into your chest, that will make it easier. Sometimes it needs to do that if you're starting to feel a bit of strain in your back. So allow the leg to come in, but offload your back if you need to. If not, keep it still. So you can hear I'm exhaling as I'm extending. Resist the temptation to take the arms miles. Just past your hairline. Two more. One more. Hug the knees. Let's rock and roll. Up into sitting. Little stretch over. Roll back on that bottom. Control that lowering. Control that lowering. From here, back into that tabletop position for both legs. Control, use your abs to get you there. Now from here, rather than one leg going out, we're gonna send both. Now that might be too much for some of you. So we're going to control, get up to tabletop position again. One, two, arms, three. So you can stick with that level. So arms going back with alternating leg, or we can load up again and do two legs. So in that V shape, don't let your back arch, hold your tummy flat, breath out. Breath in, control. Resist the temptation, take your arms miles, feel long in the leg, lengthen through, strong core, working your lower and upper abdominal area. Breath in. Two more. Hold that shape, hold your form, remember your levels if it's too much. Hug those knees. Stretch your arms out long. Get yourself into that little hug position. Let's rock and roll up again. Well done. There's our session. 15 minutes, focused, form, poise, technique. All right, two exercises, box shape, and then we're on our back. There's lots of different levels, choose your level, don't over egg it. Okay, that session's done nicely on its own, but works perfectly with the upper body, then the leg routine, then that routine. Okay, I hope you enjoyed that. Please share, please subscribe. More to come. Enjoy.